Okay, so let's start. Thank you for coming and welcome to this session. Title is Webform versus Entityform, exposing forms to end users, and I'm going to try to show and compare different ways to create forms to our visitors to enter their information and get feedback or information from them. Let me introduce myself first. My name is Pablo López. I'm López both in Drupal.org and Twitter, and I work for Drupal, and when I'm not doing Drupal, I used to play handball. So that's the plan. So let's go to start explaining what we are going to talk about in this session. We are going to talk about survey forms. Survey forms is kind of the concept of forms we create in our sites to get extra information from the users, get feedback, contact forms. At the end is all the information we are getting from the external world to improve or give a better situation to our site. So we need to take into account that this information shouldn't be considered as website content. I mean, website content, as we can understand it, is the notes, views, or whatever we want to show to the world. But the survey forms, we are getting information that it's from the world. So it's not theoretically thought to be shown, at least how it is created. So different Drupal alternatives we have to create this kind of forms is, of course, use the form API, but there is a lot of stuff that has to be done, so I think it's not worth to create a form API because it's a lot of work, and we are in Drupal, and we have modules for that to do all that kind of work. Other thing we can do for this is create a generic content type and try to expose that form for that content type to our end users, but this is kind of risky because, as I said before, this is not content and we are creating content types, so notes can be published, notes can be interacted by other modules or appear in some listings that probably are not interested in. Also, content types create new permissions, new options. So we are going to create a lot of things around the form that we are not interested to have. Other option is to try to embed an external system, but you can embed in an iframe a Google Docs form, but that's not elegant. We are creating something professional. There are also modules that try to integrate external tools and synchronize their survey results, like a limb survey sync module, and also have survey form modules. These are the kind of modules we are interested in, the kind of modules we are going to talk in this session. So let's describe them in more detail. So survey form modules are modules that allow to create multiple survey forms in a site, and also they allow to store the results to be processed after that. I mean, processed, we can create analytics, we can export the data, we can do a lot of things and processing to get what we want with that data. Also give support for notification to our end users and access control. With access control, I mean the number of times that someone can submit the form, the roles that are allowed to access to the form. All of that should be support in an easy way, configurable way, and not creating a lot of permissions and all that stuff, as I commented with the content type approach. So we have different options for this, but there are two big players in this game. These players are Webform and Entityform, and those are the modules I'm going to show you and compare along the session. So let's start with Webform. Webform is an old friend in the Drupal world. It was created in 2004. We have hundreds of thousands of installations of this module. tons of releases. So this module also has a lot of feedback from the community, and it has been improving more and more along the time. And it has been the de facto standard for maybe a lot of sites in Drupal 6 and Drupal 7, I think. Probably people, when asked for a form, they directly install the module and then ask it for the how the form should be done, because it's a great module, and I think almost everyone has used it in the past. The key features about the module is that it's a specific survey form tool built on top of Drupal. So it's kind of not using the entity API, it's not using all that stuff, because it creates their own database schema to improve the scalability, and has, of course, the built-in support for the most usual tasks we need to do with survey forms. One of the things, and the most interesting things around the Webform module, is that it creates the form. On top of Drupal nodes, it creates the Webform content types, and also have hundreds of add-on modules. There is a huge ecosystem of modules around Webform that integrates them it with a lot of systems like rules, like features, and so on. If we have a quick look to the Webform UI, we have something similar to the node. It's a node itself, so we have the view and edit tab, and we have two new tabs, the form tab and the result tab, where you can create in the first one the form itself and configure the main things and the emails to notificate and so on. And the second one is where you see the list of the submissions, and you can process, get the analytics, download them in Excel file directly, or even clear the data. And that's something built on top of the node page. Entity form is a modern one. It was created in 2011, and it has a good number of installations, but it's much more smaller than Webform, because it's only 15,000 installations. But it was created for Drupal 8 and thinking in the Drupal 8 architecture, so it's created with all the subsystems, it's using Entity API. In fact, it's an entity. So the features is that it's integrated with the entity stuff, but it requires to have some experience with the Drupal UI, because it's not so intuitive like Webform, and also requires some other modules for the usual task. For instance, it almost requires views to prepare the data and so on. But on the other hand, it's really easy to integrate with almost everything in Drupal, because it was thought to be part of Drupal, not something built on top of Drupal. And if we have the UI, it's very similar to the, for instance, the content type or any other entity UI. In fact, it's reusing the manas fields tab to create the form itself, and adds two new tabs like the form submissions, where it's just a couple of leads. It's much simpler than the other one, but it also works. So we now, what are we talking about? We are talking about forms. We are talking about these two modules. We now have works both modules. So let's compare them. I divided this comparison in 7 blocks, depending on the main features. And let's go there. So the first one is about the storage and scalability of these modules and the forms created by them. As I said before, Webform module creates its own table, and all the data is stored in a single table in the database, and entity form is reusing the entity system. As you know, the fields in the created are spread along the database. Each field creates a new database table. It's kind of different stuff, so we can have scalability problems in case we have a huge number of items performed on a huge number of forms in the same site. If we are talking about the storage and scalability, Webform is a better solution than Entityform. If we move to the form creation options, we know that Webform is attached to a node while Entityform creates its own page. But as you can see, Webform has almost all this stuff built in by default because it's a specific tool for cyber phones, so you can get the submission access, the submission limit, the draft support, the availability as block. While we need something else for Entityform, we need some country module to get the block support, but mainly we can do all the everything with both. So it's something easier to do with Webform, but Entityform could work too. Moving to the next one, probably is one of the keys, is the form field. So Entityform, as it's based on field API, you can reuse any field type and any module providing a field we have in our Drupal sites, like we can have geofields, we can have complex address fields, and are built in by default in the Entityform stack, while Webform provides just 9 form field types by default. But as said before, we have a lot of country modules providing new features, but it's kind of difficult because if you want to work with addresses, you have the address field in your site to work with your fields. You have also the kind of country module on top of Webform, so it's kind of duplicated stuff here. But we have other stuff interesting for forms, like the multi-page, conditional fields, or grouping fields that, of course, are built in by default in Webform, but you can do it, of course, with some country stuff in Entityform, like field groups or multi-page. It's different options, but you can get, again, almost done with this. About the survey features, it's something similar. Well, survey features are the specific stuff we create for surveys, like the download and process the data and the notifications for users. We have a basic, not basic, but limited built-in support in Webform, but you can integrate Entityform easily with some country modules like views, rules, or view data export to get the same stuff. So, or even more flexible, because you can use views, you can integrate all of them, so you can try to join complex data while the data export in Webform, it just downloads the result. So it's more flexible, but you need to configure your own views. And something similar for the chat. You can create fancy charts with their results, but we need to work in both cases because they are not integrated by default in any of the modules. And about theming, when I talk about theming, I'm talking about how to create a markup. I'm not talking about CSS because both modules can edit the CSS, of course, with the theming stuff. But one of the important things is the template suggestions. It's built in using some kind of a templating name in Webform. But in Entityform, we need to create some kind of custom code. We need to create some hooks to try to implement this. So it's easy for us who are site builders to do it easily with the need to write any code in Webform. Panels integration is another interesting stuff if we want to show it in a pane. We need the Entityform pane, so the Entityform block for the Entityform module, but it's built in by default in the Webform module. But other interesting stuff is if you want to create complex markups moving around all the fields, or you want to present the same form in a different way with different layouts, it's not possible with Webform, because for the panels integration, the form is treated like a whole. So it's a component itself, and you can place it, but it's the whole component. While The entity form one you can split and you can put any field in a different place or in a different order depending on our panel. So I think it's much more flexible in this way. I thought if you want to hard code the templating, it's better to use the Webform one. And talking about integration with other system, of course, we already said it before, entity form was created thinking in Drupal 7, thinking in entities, so it has built-in support to be integrated with almost everything we have in Drupal. While we need some kind of stuff with Webform Entity API is not currently supported fully, but builds has some kind of support, but it's complicated. You have to create some custom relationships to prepare the views. The features stuff to be deployed is there is some kind of module, but you can have some problems because the idea and the philosophy of the module itself. And one important thing is multilingual. We are creating our multilingual sites. And entity form, we have the default support for multilingual using the internationalization module, so you can just translate it as we translate any other thing in Drupal with the standard procedure, while Webform requires the Webform localization module, like it's kind of a module that provides some different UI, different way to treat the form, so it's kind of difficult or need some learning if you are familiar with the standard Drupal way to do the things. And about deployment, usually we need to deploy or we want to synchronize our data in our sites. Webform was created 11 years ago and it's kind of old module when all that stuff of export configuration and all this was not yet available for all of us in Drupal. So it was thought that something dynamic is attached to a node, so you can create a node that it's content, and usually we don't export the content itself. So we don't have the by default the idea to export and deploy the Webform stuff. While entity form is created as an entity, so we can export like other content type or any other entity type. So it's easy and we can do it in a kind of a standard way. About the target user for each module, Webform was created thinking in end users. It creates its own UI for the forms and tries to make it as easier as possible for everyone who is not familiar with the Drupal UI and try to standardize and using modules like Form Builder and so on, it provides an easy drag and drop UI to create the forms. While the entity form, we need to be familiar with the field API stuff and to configure all the variables in a field. So it's more indicated for kind of admin users or people who have some knowledge of how Drupal works. So the built-in deployment is not supported in Webform, but it is in entity form, as we have seen. But about the deploy strategies here, entity form can be deployed easily with features, while Webform has a different strategies. We have the features strategy using the Webform UUID module, but it's not working. Sometimes it needs to be a specific stuff. You need to configure it in a specific way, so it needs some work. Or using that kind of external stuff, like you can create a node export module, you can export your web form in your local or your dev environment, and then go to your production environment and import that node. But it's kind of, you can also have the typical problems with the node IDs and so on. So Webform is not designed for that. So to recap this comparison, you have seen that there is no golden hammer solution for all the situations. So depending on our requirement, depending on the situation, it's better to use a different approach or not. We have seen that we can do almost everything with both modules. Depending on one things or not, we need some country modules or we need another, but we can do almost everything in both cases. But the difference is Webform is a specific tool built on top of Drupal, while Entityform is adapting the Entity API and providing all the power and all the strengths of Entity API to create survey form for other users here in Drupal. So we need to study, we need to read carefully our POIR requirements before to make our decisions about what is the best tool to use in our site. So we can't just, okay, I'm a Entity fan, I love features, and let's go to install Entity Form, and then you have a form, you have 2,000 of forms in your site, and it's, the form has 200 of fields. So you are going to break your site because you are going to hit performance a lot. On the other hand, if you want something that is going to be deployed, something that is going to be small, something that is going to be standardized, probably Webform could give you some problems because of the things we talked about. So, sorry. So to make easier these decisions, I created a list of helpful questions that I think that are interesting to ask ourselves before to make that decision. So we can ask ourselves about the number of forms, about the number of fields performed, about multilingual stuff, is going to be our site multilingual or not, and the user's experience with Drupal from the people who is going to edit and create the forms, the types of fields we are going to use, because it's not the same if we are going to use just a couple of fields. We are going to create text fields and selects and radio buttons, so we are going to need complex things like, I don't know, like address fields, or even create our custom fields here to our forms, and also the grouping experience, how we are going to deal with the submissions, what we are going to do with them. On the notification logic, there is the dynamic, the theming, the deployment. There is a lot of things we have to take into account when we create our forms, and it's interesting to ask ourselves all these questions before to make the decision. So I created a couple of examples to see how we can do it for us. So the first example is a course feedback site where we allow people to log in your site, create their user, and create courses and with a description, and then create a form. We don't have any limitation about the form. It can be how they want. And we are going to allow just to submit once the form per user, and we are going to just to notify to the site owner who someone has filled the form, and just allow to download to the creator of the survey all the results in an Excel file. So if we ask ourselves all the questions, we can see that Entity Form couldn't be a good option because of the scalability. We can have a lot of forms in our site. We don't know how many fields we are going to have in each form. Also, the user experience, we need to talk about that because it's going to be used by end users. So we don't know if they are familiar with all the Drupal UI and how Drupal works. The multi-page support is better in the Webform than Entity Form. And also the data extraction is simpler and built in there, and the dynamically of the form, because are going to be moved and used by users, and we don't know how often they are going to modify the forms and the questions, and also the specific replacement, because we are going to show the form behind the description. It just done by default in Webform, while in Entityform we need to create the node, we need to create the form, and we need to figure out the way to put both together in a single page. So in this case, Webform wins. But we have a second example where it's a job application for a big site. We are working with a big company with a lot of countries. It's multilingual. We have tons of users. But we don't know just a form. It's just a submission form. We have some kind of address fields, but we need just one form, but we need to place it in different ways and with different layouts. So in this case, we don't have problems with scalability because we are not going to have a lot of items and we are not to have a lot of forms, but we can have problems with multilingual in Webform because it's not using the standard way, or the field types, because if we are going to use other fields or complex stuff, we are not going to be support by Webform. Well, we can do it easily with Entityform. But also we have some kind of problem with the notifications. Imagine we come to notify to all the users with a 13 role and living in the same country that the user who submitted the form. So that kind of complex logic can't be done with Webform, and it's easy to implement with rules if we are working with Entityform. And the same about the placement of the form, because we can use panels or other options to create different layouts to show in different ways in different parts of the page. So in this second case, Entityform wins. So depending on the situation, we have to take into account all the concepts and go there and make the best decision. So now it's your turn. Now it's your turn to decide what's your best tool for you in any case, because there is nothing right on stone here. So let's talk a bit about Drupal 8 and how it's the future of these forms in Drupal 8. And moving to the Webform stuff, it's kind of not chaotic but different like in Drupal 7, because there is a new team of maintainers. Nate Hall, who was in the Drupal, leading the Drupal 7 Webform, now moved to Backdrop and is not working in Drupal 8 anymore. And Webform is a tool, is using their own UI, so need to redesign, need to rewrite a lot of stuff, because almost everything has to be done from scratch for Drupal 8. They have the idea, they have the architecture, but almost all the code have to be rewritten again. And we have, again, a problem with the country modules. Having a lot of country modules around Webform is great. In Drupal 7, you can integrate. You have tons of extensions. You can do almost everything using that country modules. But for Drupal 8, we have two problems. The first one is that we need first to have Webform working in Drupal 8 to be able to update and to port all those modules. And the second one is that we need that maintainers will be able and will be interested in porting those modules to Drupal 8, because sometimes people create a module because they need it, sure, but it's not interested in maintaining it anymore, or just because there is a huge number of people using that module and it's not so easy to port to Drupal 8. So I don't know exactly how Webform will be ready for Drupal 8, but there's people working on that. But to have all the functionalities, to have all the country stuff and all the availability we have in Drupal 7, we will need probably a long time. On the other hand, with Entityform, it's a different situation. Well, Entityform has been renamed for Drupal 8. It's going to be eForm, because we have some kind of naming issues with the entity form namespace. And the same people who created the module is still maintaining it. Bowman is going to take in the responsibility of porting the module to Drupal 8. But we need to move the module to a Drupal 8 architecture, but it's much easier, I think, than the Webform situation, because entity form is reusing all the entity architecture. Entity form is reusing all the entity UI. Entity form is using modules like that were in the past country modules like views or the entity API module that now are in Drupal core. So we already can work on top of that to create a module and to try to evolve. So, and also helpful modules like rules or field group that are kind of required to be used in Drupal 7 to have a full experience with entity form are generic modules that almost everyone is using in Drupal site. So there is a huge community wanting to have all those modules ported. People who is maintaining those modules is already working on Drupal 8 and is having some advance there. So all the things are making that E4 module will be ready for Drupal 8, I think, soon. Probably in the next weeks they have the first working beta of the entity form module for Drupal 8. So if you want to work on this in E4, Webform, or any other stuff, you can attend to sprints on Friday. I encourage you to attend to sprints to learn and to help with Drupal. And here, finally, is a list of interesting resources to if you want to give a deep research on this. You have the Webform project, the Entity Form project, links to different sessions about Webform in DrupalCon, documentation, another post about the comparison of these two modules. So I think that's something interesting, and you can use it as you want. So now it's time for questions. Oh, yeah.
So I started to use entity forms because I couldn't find a solution for Webform that is similar to field collections. Do you know a country for Webform that does this? I found some attempts, but they were really limited.
No, I don't know any alternative to field collection for Webform. Welcome.
Hi. Yeah. I also have a quick use case question for Webform. In Webform, you can specify the amount of submissions you get for the entire form. But is there an add-on or a solution to specify that if a certain answer has been given a certain amount of times, then that question becomes disabled or something? If you understand.
No, in entity form, it's built by default in Webform. You have the time window when you give the options for the number of submissions. But in entity form, I think you can create it with rules.
But that's the amount of submissions for the entire form that you mean, right? Or
sorry, I can go.
is that the like the total amount of submissions for the entire form that you're talking about? In entity
yeah.
form? Yeah. But my question is specifically within Webform or any form, for a certain question. Say you have a question with radio boxes.
Yeah.
And if, like, let's say 5 times the answer A has been given, can you disable that option from the question in Webform?
Disable that option? Well, by default, it's kind of complex situation.
Yeah.
So I think that's not possible. with Webform, you can use the hooks provided by Webform, and when you submit the form, try to make the logic and then disable it programmatically. But I think probably that's one. Or you could use the Webform rules module and create a rule that does that, that creates, that checks the number of times that that option has been selected, and if it's reached, that set the Webform status to zero and then publish it.
Okay, thanks.
Welcome.
I just wanted to answer your question. There's a module called Webform Multiple, and you can use it in conjunction with field sets, and then you have some kind of a field collection you can use multiple times. Okay.
No more questions, so thank you.
Thank you.